With the latest success of No Time to Die, the Bond movie formula has certainly stood the test of time. The essential ingredients, of course, a charming lead, a deadly villain, and of course, very fast cars.
Yeah, now some of Bond's most memorable motors, including the gadget-filled Aston Martin DB5, have gone on show at the National Motor Museum. Tom Hepworth has been along.
Mirror, signal, manoeuvre. Yes, Bond is back, and so's his Aston Martin. The beefed-up, bashed-up DB5 is the centrepiece of the new exhibition.
Cars have always played a huge role in James Bond films. In fact, in some, they've even overshadowed the plot itself. Has anybody seen an invisible Aston Martin Vanquish?
Can I just have one nice evening, please, before the world explodes?
It's an absolute thrill to see all these cars here and see some of the props. I'm very excited and I've come along to keep the British end up.
We tell the history of motoring right up to the present day. And, you know, let's face it, lots of people at the moment are talking about No Time to Die. So it's absolutely appropriate that a film that has so many cars in it, I mean, let's face it, after the actors, they are the most important characters in the film.
We all have our secrets. We just didn't get to yours yet.
The man who does have all the secrets is the real-life Q behind the cars and gadgets in 15 Bond films.
There was a lot of topic of conversation was what should the gadgets be in this? Should we stick to the original ones from Goldfinger or should they be upgraded? And the fact that they've been blown up and rebuilt in Spectre gave us the scope to upgrade the guns. You know, we went from the single barrel Browning to the multi-barrel miniguns. You know, the mines that came out of the back were explosive mines rather than just tyre spikes. We stayed traditional with a smoke screen, but we had a lot of fun with it. And it was so great after all those years to see it back in full combat mode in the beautiful town of Matera in Italy.
When it comes to filmmaking, continuity is key, which is why this Defender has been spray painted to make it look as though it's been off-roading, so they don't have to wash it down after every scene.
Have you ever flown one of these things before?
Nope.
But sometimes there are ideas that just don't fly.
There are times where you can go for months sitting in the art department, you might as well just connect the printer straight to the shredder because you know this idea is just going to go straight through the meetings and out the other end and no one's going to pay any attention to it. But sometimes you know you've hit the nail on the head and it all just works perfectly. There were three or four versions of this glider until we finished with the nice looking one up there.
Now, be honest, who hasn't secretly wanted to move a lane hog with a missile or discourage an aggressive tailgater with a smokescreen, or perhaps even restore a little calm to the car with an ejector seat? There's only one car that can do that, and that's this, the Aston Martin DB5. Now, if you'll excuse me, Miss Moneypenny, I've got to get back to the studio. There's no time to drive.
Great.
Tom was enjoying that, wasn't he? He was really enjoying that. It's kind of your Jeremy Clarkson moment if you get the sense to do something like that, isn't it? You know, window down, leaning out, bombing off in a great car.
Have you seen it yet?
No. It's
no,
on my
me
list.
Neither.
I've got to catch
weekend.
Up on the Crown first,
Next
my goodness.
Yeah, you do.
I'll get
God.
To see it eventually.
It's really embarrassing will. How far behind you are.
I'm working on it.